The Pap Attack.
Fascism is a word that's overused when one political interest group is describing the bad conduct of another opposition political interest group. The politics of fascism, it's not difficult to understand, but I've heard plenty of college professors complicate the definition of fascism to the point that it would be tough to recognize if it came up and knocked on your front door. Simple thing is, at the core of fascism, you're always going to find unchecked power of big money industrialists controlling the message of mass media. That's it in its basic form. You could search history books forever and you'd never find an instance where those two essential elements of fascism weren't present. Typically, it occurs when a powerful political leader gains the backing of moneyed industrialists, and together with force, they silence the watchdog voice of mass media.
I drink your milkshake.
But oddly enough, last week it was the U.S. Supreme Court that laid the groundwork for a powerful political leader to join well-financed industrialists and gain control over America's airways. The court determined that a company like Exxon could use as much of their $40 billion annual profits as they chose to wage limitless corporate media campaigns against any political opponent who opposes Exxon's gluttonous, rapacious view of the world. The Supreme Court completely nullified John McCain's 2002 campaign finance reform bill, known as the McCain-Feingold bill. McCain has spent the better part of his political career warning the American public that unless we limit extortion-level campaign money in politics, democracy is going to die. His fear is legitimate. A limitless flow of money from corporations like Exxon or Halliburton or Goldman Sachs can easily buy an election. There are a couple of factors that close the deal. The corporate media is going to sell Exxon as much airtime as necessary to buy a politician and to buy an election. And in the process, the media is going to sell their neutrality and their objectivity. I mean, after all, why would NBC corporate executives have their news departments attack Exxon or Exxon's candidate on anything short of genocide when Exxon is pumping billions of dollars into NBC's bank account? It's corporate America's version of the golden rule. Simply put, people with the gold make all the rules. In 2008, $5.3 billion was spent in the media on political advertising. Expect that number to grow geometrically in the next presidential race, and imagine how the dying TV and newspaper industry is looking forward to that new cash bonanza delivered by the U.S. Supreme Court. Exxon and Exxon's political stooge of the day, well, they won't silence the media with AK-47s and a coup d'etat. Exxon instead is going to put their trained politico monkey in place with the power of gold. Alan Dershowitz wrote a book years ago where he pointed out that Supreme Court Judge Antonin Scalia's father was an active member of the American-Italian Fascist Party. In fact, Dershowitz points out that as a child, Scalia was placed in a military school where many children of the American-Italian Fascist Party were educated. Antonin obviously paid very close attention in class. He was a good student. Scalia didn't write the opinion that put a real face to John McCain's fear, but you can bet he led the fight as five predictable Republican-picked judges exhibited the stature of five circus midgets who stumbled all over themselves to please their corporate benefactors. In their minds, well, it was democracy be damned. John McCain is right. This is a huge problem.
And you will be bought.